Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab, and today I'm going to unbox the Solantec 20 kilowatt hybrid inverter. You may not have heard of Solantec. In fact, I'm new to the brand myself, but meeting the people from Solantec at the All Energy Show was great and learning about their range of inverters. They really do some big hybrid inverters. Now, I've only got a small one here, the 20 kilowatt three-phase hybrid. Wow, that's a lot of inverter, and that's their small one. But boy, unboxing it was fun, I can tell you. It came in not one, but two boxes. So to leave the show a little bit faster, to make it run a bit quicker, I'm just going to show you getting it out of the crate, and then we're going to go inside the package and talk about the product in terms of its features, what it can do, and some of its use case applications. Anyway, let's dive into it. Well, rather than just watch me running like a blue-assed fly, let's talk about this MHT20K-40 hybrid inverter. So it's a Solantec 20 kilowatt inverter with a 98.4% maximum efficiency. That's pretty damn efficient. A maximum charge discharge current of 40 amps. Now you might not think this doesn't sound very much, but when you consider this actually goes up to a 750 volt battery, 135 minimum, it will really move some power at that sort of current level. One of the really big features of this unit is its 110% unbalanced output rating. That means it can supply single phase loads completely out of balance, so you're not having to export all your beautiful stored solar energy out to the grid just because you've got unbalanced loads. It has a 10 millisecond switching time on its backup circuit, which means you'll probably never know that you've lost power. So this thing is really plug and play, lots of terminals on the bottom, and IP65, it's gonna go outside.
Well, that was a bit of hard working out of the box. You really should do this with two people, but here I am by myself in the studio lifting 31 kilos. Now, I was doing it carefully so I wouldn't strain my back, but I do not recommend lifting 31 kilos by yourself, particularly when it comes to mounting an inverter like this on the wall. But anyway, let's have a closer look at the components that were in the box. So I've already unpackaged them so it's kind of easy to see. Let's just turn this around a little bit so we can see this unit. Now, I'll take all these bits off. These are the connectors for all the ports. Now, one of the great things about an inverter like this is there's no internal wiring. Everything is done across the bottom here, and it's all weather rated IP65. So let's start with, over the far side, we've got our backup. So our backup AC connector. Now remember, this can back up 20 kilowatts of three-phase power with 110% continuous unbalanced load. That means one phase can have all of the load plus another 10% on it while the other phase is doing nothing. So that's our backup, and it's black. So it connects in here, and we wire the three phases into the plug. The red one, is labeled on-grid. So this is our on-grid connector. Our on-grid connector, labeled red, looks very similar. It's also, of course, a three-phase connector, and it's three actors, a neutral and earth. Then we've got our multi-port data connector here. So for connecting things like demand response enabled devices or any DRED functionality, so that goes in here. We've got the ubiquitous Wi-Fi dongle. Now I say ubiquitous because really it's a pretty standard feature on most inverters these days. It makes it very easy to commission an inverter. All you need is your phone and stand in front of it. So Wi-Fi dongle and the app, of course. So the Wi-Fi dongle plugs in here, and it is IP65. And looks like it's got some little status lights on the front there. Coming across this way, we've got first up our battery port. Now, our battery, remember this takes 135 to I think it's 950 volt battery, so that's pretty impressive. And we can plug those in here. So these are slightly different. These are blue, and they've also got different size pins, because these can carry, I think, up to 40 amps. So they're a pretty heavy duty pin. So there they are. I think I've got them. I just mixed them all up here on the table. But yeah, that's our heavy duty pins for our battery ports. So battery connects in here. The PV connectors. Now, this is a really important feature, is that these are provided with the appropriate pins and sockets, and it's easy to get this around the wrong way. So that is a male pin and that is a female socket, right? Pretty obvious. But when you go to put them in their appropriate holders, it's quite confusing, because this is actually the male plug. See, it looks female, but it's a male plug. And this is the female socket. It's kind of counterintuitive when you just look at the outside casing. You've got to remember it's the pins inside that matter. So the other thing I really want to point out is, I mean, it's great that Solentec provide you with all these components, because it's a requirement that plug and socket connections are the same type, same brand, both sides of the connection. So this needs to be the same brand, same type as here. And because this is not a standard connector, there are many brands of these connectors, but Solentec provides matching ones for you. The other hot tip is when you're installing, when you're actually crimping these, it's important that you use the right tool. There is a special tool for doing like the figure eight crimp. You only need to strip just enough cable to go into the little U-bend on the end of the pin. Doesn't have to go right inside the pin itself. And once you've crimped it using the appropriate tool, you don't have to take off physical restraint, mechanical restraint and waterproofing connector. You just poke it in and it goes click. Push it in until it goes click, and tighten this up really well so that there is no chance of water getting past the rubber gland in there. I usually have a little look through it, see if I can see any daylight. If I have, I haven't tightened it up enough. So that's one of the biggest failure points in installation of PV arrays, is mismatched plug and sockets or incorrectly crimped and not properly sealed plug and sockets. So that's really important. So next up here, we've got a little screwdriver with some ferrules. No doubt that'll be for things like data cables that you may need to install for demand response enabled devices or DRED. We've got wall mounting plugs here. So this is for solid walls, brick and concrete, etc. And then we've got a couple of knobs, which I'm actually not sure what they're for, but there we go. There was a couple of knobs. I think they may well be for sealing off something, but we'll find out once we read the manual. So I do these unboxings just like many installers do, just go for it. And, you know, please just don't ring support as soon as you have a problem. That's the time, is to go and read the manual. The manual will provide you with a lot of information. So there's your bedtime reading. But today, I'm just opening the box, and from experience, we'll try to work stuff out. The most important feature of a hybrid inverter, apart from the fact that it's providing you with backup power, AC power to your loads, and also exporting to the grid if you're allowed to, is this. This is the energy meter. Now, the energy meter needs to be installed preferably at the main switchboard, but at least upstream of the loads that you want to support. Because if it can't see in the consumption of those loads, then the inverter doesn't know when to support them, i.e. export power from solar or battery to support them. It's got three CTs because it is a three-phase inverter. So we'll put our three CTs around the three actives, and it's important to put them around the right way. So very handily, it's labeled house and grid. Sometimes it's just a letter. Sometimes you'll just see K or L or whatever. I love this one. House, grid, with a little arrow. So you know which way it needs to be clipped onto the cable. Because this is the other very common fault, is incorrectly installing the CTs turns your hybrid inverter into the reverse. Instead of it saving you money, it costs you money. It tries to import energy when it should be exporting, and vice versa. So it's very important that that's connected. Now this meter is communicating with the inverter over here via a data cable with RJ45 connectors pre-made on it. This one's labeled meter, so it says meter here, and it plugs in, I'm guessing, into the RJ45 port on the meter itself. That's really nice, because I seem to be picking up all the common faults here is miswiring the data cable. When you're provided with just a blank cable and you've got to get the right pins, so there'll be data positive, data negative, ground, and if you don't get them in the right combinations, no communication. And it's not easy to test. You can't just do it with a multimeter. So this is pre-wired for you. It looks pretty long. So I think there's plenty of cable there. And this one is labeled BMS, Battery Management System. So this will be connecting to a battery system that is plugged in here, and it provides the communication back to the from between the battery and the inverter itself. Now, the reason for that is it's important for safety reasons that the inverter knows the state of health of the battery, particularly a managed battery. And a managed battery is one that actually can be often charged quite rapidly, but it needs to know what the safe parameters are. So the battery communicates those parameters back to the inverter, and the inverter controls them in terms of charge current and discharge current. So that's your BMS. And lastly, we've got this very small little mounting bracket. It's amazing. 31 kilo inverter. Clips onto this mounting bracket. I'm guessing that's the security screw on the end there. But once again, have to find that out by checking the manual. So there we go. This is the Solentec 20 kilowatt hybrid inverter. Just to reiterate, one of the special features is that 110% unbalanced load, continuous rated. In fact, 200%. For 60 seconds. Now that is quite an awesome feature. 31 kilos on the wall, two people, and commission it with your mobile phone, and away you go. So anyway, that is it.